Hi, welcome back to You Are the Answer, and thanks for having the courage to check us out again, especially after my filibuster on carbohydrates last time. Today's going to be a much shorter talk, though, but it's really important because we're going to talk about muscle energy, what it is, where it comes from, and how to get more of it so you can do epic shit. For those of you who might have missed the last episode, let's start with a quick review. Of the three macronutrients, carbs convert the fastest and most efficiently to glycogen. Glycogen is stored in both the liver and the muscles, but you have four times as much glycogen in the muscles. And glycogen is crucial because it's a really important intermediary between the food that you eat and the real energy source, ATP. ATP stands for adenosine triphosphate, and it's made through a series of complex digestive and chemical processes in your body, and then it's stored in your muscles. It's basically made out of one big adenosine molecule and then three phosphate groups all bound together. The energy doesn't come from the ATP itself, though. It comes from the bonds between the phosphates, specifically the bond between the last two phosphates. Now what happens is your nervous system sends a signal to your muscles to do some kind of work, like maybe to lift a cup of coffee or get underneath a barbell loaded with some heavy ass shit to do some squats. And that signal then causes the bond between the last two phosphates to split, releasing some mad energy for explosive muscle contraction. But that energy lasts for only a few seconds, which is just about enough time to get the bar out of the rack. And the byproducts that are left over from that ATP breakdown are pretty much useless until you can get another phosphate to attach back to the ATP mothership. Now the body's constantly making ATP as long as you have the right stuff needed to make it. The stuff that you need is food, and that's specifically carbs that help refill glycogen levels. But this process takes a while, and meanwhile you're standing in the middle of the squat rack with a shit ton of weight on your back, and you need ATP right now. That's where this stuff called phosphocreatine comes in. Like ATP, phosphocreatine is a high-energy phosphate. It's not energy in and of itself, but it works super fast to make more ATP by providing the last phosphate to link back to the mothership. This stuff also has a pretty short shelf life. Like ATP, it runs out really quickly. However, it does give your muscles about another 10 to 12 seconds of explosive power, which is about enough time to pound out a few reps and then get the bar back to the rack. Not every workout consists of big weight and low reps. You're going to need ATP at different rates for different intensity levels. Your body uses three energy systems to make ATP that'll support pretty much any training need. The difference between them is the amount of energy produced and the time that it takes to refuel it. The phosphagen system is the big block V8 of the three systems. It provides a ton of power, but it runs out really quickly. You only get about 15 seconds of really explosive energy. This would be the system used by the meatheads and headbangers like me, who like lifting heavy barbells and dumbbells for 1 to 5 reps. Or it's used for any other type of short duration, explosive movement that requires maximum force. This system also takes the longest to reset. You gotta figure about a 2 to 3 minute rest between sets or work intervals before you can go hard again. The next is the lactate system, which is sort of like the turbocharged V6 of the three. It doesn't provide as much power as the V8, but it provides energy over a longer time frame, say about 30 to 45 seconds before it runs out. And it only takes about 30 to 90 seconds to reset. Now this would be the primary fuel system that'd be used by CrossFitters training in high intensity WODs or weightlifters that are doing reps in the 10 to 15 range. Both the phosphagen system and the lactate systems are for really high intensity training and work without oxygen, which makes them anaerobic systems. But the last of the three systems, the aerobic system, depends heavily on oxygen. Out of the three systems, this system provides the least amount of power, but it lasts a long time for say 3 minutes or more with little or no rest to reset it. This is the system that would be used by most endurance athletes who train at low intensity levels for long, slow distances. Your body's actually going to use a mix of all three systems in most training. Your goals are going to be what determine which one gets the most emphasis. So be sure to tune in for the next three videos where we're going to explain how you can maximize muscle energy by coordinating your training with the appropriate fuel system. For now, thanks for checking us out again, and we'll see you next time.